So today I am going to discuss about the how forensic psychological technique is useful in crime investigation. Basically, many experts already they have given about the views. So as I am the HOD and I am working in CFSL CBI, basically we are using the forensic psychological technique only for the crime investigation purpose. Because all of you know that forensic psychological technique are useful for other purpose also, as a NEMANS and other medical centers, psychiatric centers, they are using. But basically we are using this technique only for the crime investigation. So I am going to explain briefly how I am using that this technique is useful for crime investigation with Supreme Court of India guideline. And both are human beings. So this is the main thing. So forensic psychology in India, if you will see, it starts from the time of the Akbar and Birbal time. So basic principle is there only detection of, because forensic psychology is an applied field of psychology which measure the behavior or to understand the behavior behind the crime and offense. So basically in every technique, this is the common thing, detection of fear. So crime investigation using psychological principle started in India from the time of Akbar and Birbal. So there is a one story I just want to tell you about that thing. Because how the detection of fear is important. Only this component is involved in the psychological technique. One morning, a minister from Akbar court gathered in the assembly hall and he informed the emperor that all his valuable had been stolen by a thief by the previous night. So Akbar invited Birbal to solve the mystery. He ordered all the ministers to lift the donkey tail and say, "I have not stolen." So all the ministers except Alim Khan had a black patch of paint on their palm. So Birbal had actually painted the donkey's tail with a black coat of paint. In the fright, the guilty minister did not touch the donkey's tail at all. So main principle, main component is here, fear of detection. So in lie detection, the truth verification technique in India is started in CFSL CBI, New Delhi. A full-fledged first lie detection division in India was established in the year 1972-73 by Dr. Gangli and Dr. Lahiri to provide scientific support for verifying the veracity of the statement of subjects involved in criminal cases during investigation. And then the first forensic psychology division in India by renaming lie detection division at Forensic Science Laboratory Ahmedabad was initiated by Dr. Selvaya. And he established in 1988. So if you will see in many criminal cases, material evidence, eyewitness, may not be available. But in all probability, the case will have some suspect and victim, that is the human being. So forensic psychology is an applied field of psychology which measures the behavior or understand the behavior behind the crime and offense. The evaluation of human behavior in investigation through psychological technique can be useful for the investigating officer. In the field of forensic, you will see the forensic psychology is the only discipline that deals with a living human being. Because here information directly from person, not from any physical materials. So forensic psychologist can identify the deceptive and truthful person in any type of situation. So the use of forensic psychological technique in the capability of the police investigation and automatically discourage the use of third degree method in police interrogation. So all these are the existing forensic psychological tool: polygraph, brain fingerprinting, BIOS, brain mapping, narco analysis, forensic psychological assessment, layered wise analysis, forensic statement analysis, psychological autopsy, suspect detection system, and criminal profiling. So as a with Supreme Court guideline, the consent of subject before a judicial magistrate is required. In polygraph, in brain mapping, and in narco test, the consent of subject before a judicial magistrate is required. In forensic statement analysis, in forensic psychological assessment, in layer-wise analysis, criminal profiling, psychological autopsy, in suspect detection system, the consent of subject before a judicial magistrate is not required. Only the expert will take the consent. So only the narco technique is invasive technique, and all are non-invasive technique. Polygraph, brain mapping, forensic statement analysis, forensic psychological assessment, layer wise analysis, psychological autopsy, all are the non-invasive technique. So main objective, why we are using all this forensic psychological technique? The main objective is to find out the truth and deception of the subject, to identify the deceptive person. And this is very much important to exonerate the innocent. Many times when investigating officer is investigating the cases, and suppose there are 10 subjects. So with the help of technique, he can eliminate the innocent persons. So that is the main advantage of all this technique, because on this basis, the IU can eliminate that person or the innocent. It is the third degree method also. And the IO will get the maximum information about the crime. It provides the direction to the investigator officer, identify the perpetrator of the crime. And it's very useful for examining white collar criminal economic offense and cyber another offender. So basically the main objective of forensic psychological technique to check the veracity of the statement of accused, suspect, witness and complainant. As a forensic scientist, there are many, there are many disciplines, biology, serology, document examination, many disciplines are there. But when the investigating officer is investigating the subject will give only testimony, statement. So how you will check? So with the help of forensic psychological technique, we can check the veracity of the statement of the accused, suspect, witness and complainant. Suppose witness has given one statement that I was present there and in front of me this was the happen. So how we will check? Every time the physical evidence and material evidence is not available, only the subject is given verbal testimony. So with the help of forensic psychological technique, we can check the veracity of the statement of the subject. These facilities are available in CFSL, Gandhinagar, Haryana, IB also has, Delhi Police Laboratory, UP FSL, Andhra FSL, Kerala FSL, Rajasthan FSL, Himachal FSL, and many experts are available in India. So at present, the forensic psychological technique are used in different crime investigation, in different type of crime, in forgery, cheating, homicide, suicide, in anti-corruption cases, in special crime, economic offense, and kidnapping, crime against women, and white collar crime. In all type of cases, we are using the forensic psychological technique. The user of these techniques, CBI, NIA, Army Forces, other state police department, and IP, all are using all these, the forensic psychological technique for crime investigation. So what polygraph? Polygraph is mainly known as lie detection, is available for the investigating agency for interrogation of suspect, witness, and complainant. So polygraph cannot read your mind. It can detect only bodily changes that are often the result of stress. It detects only psychophysiological responses. The equipment which is used for the purpose of truth verification, lie detection, is polygraph. And the word polygraph means it records simultaneously many writings are there, many records, many graphs. As the name indicates, the equipment can simultaneously record more than one polygraph, more than one graph. And the subject is asked a series of questions and different psychophysiological responses will come on the chart. This is the equipment. Here the subject will sit, examiner will sit here. And all these are the external attachment. There is a one-way mirror. Sometime Human Rights Commission nominated any person, that person can see the whole procedure. Sometime court nominated, that advocate will present at the time of examination. So the advocate can also see the whole procedure from the one-way mirror. This is laptop. When we are using this technique in jail or outside Delhi, then we are using this thing. So these are the external attachment in this instrument to pneumogram sensor for respiration, one galvanic skin responses, and one blood pressure cuff. All these are the external attachment. No drug induced during polygraph examination. See, how the examination is progressing and how these are the attachment. So this is one thing that you will see, all these are the external attachment, no drug induced, and it replaces the third degree method also, and the IO can get the lead from the this examination. So any test, any light detection test, the scientific basis, they are based on the psychosomatic interaction of the individual. Psycho means mental, somatic, physiological. So there is always a correspondence between human mind and body. So this is the main basis of the development of the light detection test and equipment with the polygraph. So the following physiological parameters are taken into consideration by the verification of the veracity of the statement by an individual. So respiration, blood pressure, pulse rate, and galvanic skin resistance. So these physiological function are not under the voluntary control of the individual. So these are controlled by the autonomic nervous system. So this machine measure only that thing which is controlled by autonomic nervous system. So the criminal, if the person is criminal, if the person is normal, the human physiology is the same. Any criminal cannot control that behavior which is controlled by autonomic nervous system. This is the scientific base of this polygraph examination. So this is a procedure. First, we are taking pretest interview, then question procedure, then chart interpretation, post-test interview, result and analysis. So this is the graph you can see. On this relevant question, when the person is telling lie. So in CBI, in IIM, I have done many cases in during polygraph examination, with polygraph examination. And it gives lead to the investigating officer, and it corroborates with other forensic evidence also. This is not the thing, if I am conducting polygraph and I am saying the person is deceptive and truthful, not on the basis of no conviction, no anything, charge sheet will be done only on the basis of polygraph. Polygraph is an aid to investigation. Polygraph is an aid to investigating officer. And after polygraph, it leads to the investigating officer, and then they corroborate with other forensic input. Suppose in Delhi High Court bomb blast case, and you will see there was one nail came from Kishtwar, that I have done this and that. As you know, in every terrorism cases, some group, they are taking the responsibility that I have done this thing. So in Delhi High Court bomb blast case, their first one mail came from Kishtwar. So when NIA was investigating with the cyber cell, they connect the place from where this mail came. But this is the thing. Now the second thing, how they will, because they, that was the cyber cafe. So many people were using there, they were not using the ID also at that time. So how the investigating officer will connect the suspect. So with the investigation, he select 6-7 subject. Maybe they can be suspect, means maybe may not be involved. So when I conducted the polygraph examination of 7 suspect, from among 7, the one person was totally deceptive, and it was connect that it was proof that he sent the mail. So the investigating officer find out the one person. When any investigating officer is investigating the case, he has to connect the chain also. So he got the first person. When he interrogate, then it was clear who was the second person. Then I conducted the polygraph examination on second person also. And after that, it was clear that the one doctor was there. He was from Bangladesh, and he was the main conspirator. So in this way, we find out the real culprit. So it helps the investigating officer. In Badayu rape and murder case, if you are aware about that thing, in the case, the witness testimony, the witness has given one statement that in front of me, Pappu Yadav and 5 police person, they were involved in the rape and murder of these 2 girls. This is the statement given by the witness. Whether that statement is correct or not correct, so after this case, when the case was transferred in CBI, immediately the 5 person, they were arrested and they were in jail. So when I conducted the forensic psychological assessment and polygraph from Allahabad court, they got the bail that the persons are not involved in the rape and murder case of that girl. only because of the witness statement, sometime the witness changed the direction of the cases. So only on the basis of witness, the case direction was totally changed. So when I conducted the polygraph examination, assessment, and other technique, statement analysis, after that it was clear that the police person and the two other person, they were totally innocent. And we conducted this test on witness also. And it was clear that he was telling lie totally. So the real outcome on the basis of this test, we eliminate the innocent, we exonerate the innocent. In this, I think, in Pathankot Air Base attack, all of you are clear. There was one SP, Salvinder Singh. And NIA investigate this case 2 times. So that when we are doing and applying any forensic psychological technique, the main aim is only the issue related with that particular case. When I was doing the polygraph examination on SP Salvinder Singh, there was the other issue also. He is involved in other things. He was involved in other cases also. But the main issue was NIA was only this thing, whether he was involved in terrorism activities or not, whether he has any connection with Pakistani terrorist or not. So on the basis of polygraph examination, it was clear that he was not involved in any terrorism activities. And on that basis, they eliminate that the SP Salvinder Singh is totally innocent and he is not involved in terrorism activities. So on that basis, we are trying to eliminate the innocent. We are trying to get the correct direction toward the investigation. In Sofian rape and murder case, this was the famous case of Srinagar. In that case, there was an allegation of rape and murder of 2 ladies. And after that, there was the involvement. They alleged the accused of some police person and the CRPF people. So when at the time of December at Srinagar, I conducted the polygraph examination and forensic psychological assessment of some police person, CRPF people, and they cooperate too much. When we are dealing with the human subject, it is under observation how much they are cooperating with the expert, how much they are cooperating with the investigating authority. And at the time of this December, Srinagar, night time also they were cooperating and they are ready for any test. But the doctor who has given the report of rape, she was not ready for the polygraph examination, for the any technique, for the any interrogation. Every time she is trying to escape. So naturally, because after that it was corporate, the AIMS team was also there, biologist was there, serologist was there, other physics division was there. So when the results outcome come, it corroborate with the other forensic input also. And it was clear with the reports of AIMS, that was the real drowning cases. And the doctor, lady doctor, has given the vaginal swab of other lady. And he gave the reports of rape. That was not the rape. So on that basis, you will see how the innocent people are clear and how we got investigating officer reach about the who is the real culprit. In Vyapam cases, it's a very famous case of MP Madhya Pradesh. And there was many students, they got the medical degree. And after doing the many assessment, I have conducted on about 150 subjects and it corroborate with the fingerprint and with the document examination. And court cancel the medical degree of many students on the basis of all this forensic input. So there are so many cases. I explain only 2-3. Yakub Memon, we conducted the polygraph examination on 8 days on Yakub Memon because it connect the main chain, how he was funding the only for the persons to send to Pakistan for training and how all the activities was done. So it corroborate each and every event related to that thing. See, this is the Udhampur attack case. This is very much important because everybody has seen that he is present. This was the in TV media, already he is present. So now this is the question. When he is present, everybody can see them. What is the use of polygraph? Because he's present, this is the physical present, he is present there, and he's involved in this attack. But he was the live Pakistani terrorist. And with the help of polygraph examination, we got the more information, who is the leader, and where is the camp. So it lead to recovery and arrest of other terrorist, because we are conducting, when polygraph examination, we are conducting any forensic psychological technique to extract more and more information from the subject that can be utilized for the investigation purpose. So he is present, it's everybody knows that he is involved, but with the help of technique we got more information, and that was utilized by the NIA to for the recovery and arrest of other terrorist. So brain fingerprinting, brain electrical oscillation, signature profiling. So already Professor Mukundan already elaborate this technique in detail, because Farwell developed this technique basically, and then Dr. Mukundan developed this technique in the name of brain electrical oscillation signature profiling system. And he already, in my previous session, he already explained this technique very well. So I think all of you are aware, because this technique doesn't detect lie as such. This technique only will tell you this knowledge is present and this knowledge is not present. So I am not going to explain in detail, because already Professor Mukundan explained each and every aspect about this technique. So basically, so narco analysis, it's a combination of hypnosis and narcosis to retrieve the memory of the subject. It is invasive technique. It requires complete video recording because subject is not conscious, and it's alternate to third degree interrogation. Here in narcotest, sodium emetol and sodium pentothal injection is given intravenously, and at the time of toilet state, a stage between consciousness and unconsciousness. So psychiatrists will tell now this is the toilet stage, and then the expert will conduct only interview, not interrogation, because subject is not conscious. So venue of narcoanalysis technique, this is the OT facilities. Whether if the expert is conducting in in lab, so in lab there is required the full OT facilities, and if the facilities is not available in lab, then the expert is conducting this test in hospital. So team of expert who conduct the narcoanalysis, once anesthesia doctor is required, psychiatrist, forensic clinical psychologist, supporting nursing staff, and videographer. The whole procedure of the narcoanalysis has to be videographed, and record has to be maintained, as these are the evidence. Unadded CD is required, as it is CD will be given to the court, and revelation will be written by the expert, and that will be given to the investigating officer. The subject under hypnotic trance situation, and the psychiatrist will tell that now the subject is trance situation. Then the expert will conduct only interview, no interrogation style, no leading question will be asked to the subject at the narcoanalysis time. In Itari case it was done, and many information subject revealed during narco test. And every time when we are doing any test, every individual is unique. It's not necessary if one subject is revealing more and more information, other subject will also reveal this in the same way, because every individual is unique. So accordingly, that how much he feel, how much the information feed up to in the unconscious mind of the subject, accordingly that the subject will reveal the information. So unedited CD is very much required, and the CD as it is, the report given by the expert will be given to the IU. Psychological autopsy. So this is the many important case nowadays. When all of you are listening about this Sushant Singh Rajput case, this word came in media, psychological autopsy, psychological autopsy. Many people were asking me, madam, what is the psychological autopsy? So it established the ambiguity and whether death was a result of natural cause, accident, suicide, or homicide. NASH clarification. Every time it's a critical death analysis, when it is not clear, the mode of death is not clear. So it is done by the psychological autopsy. Medical autopsy is done by the medical doctor. He will tell the cause of death. But the psychological autopsy to establish whether death was a result of natural cause, accident, suicide, or homicide. In general, you will see some death cases are very equivocal death. For example, death of parachute driver, maybe accident. If the parachute does not open, maybe murder. If the faulty one was given to him intentionally, and maybe case of suicide if he knows the condition of parachute prior to use. In the case of hanging, it may be suicide if he himself hanged, maybe murder if someone hanged him, or even it may be accident if he was just demonstrating. So the same thing, hanging is one thing and the mode is different. So when many time in many type of cases, it is equivocal death. It's not clear whether it is suicide, murder, accident. At that time, the expert, we are using the psychological autopsy. So psychological autopsy refers to the analysis of the state of mind of the victim prior to his or death and at the time of death. In case where the manner of death is unexplained and it is not clear what happened, a psychological autopsy may assist in clearing up the mystery. So psychological autopsy is retrospective reconstruction of the diseased life with a view to understand better the thought, attitude, and motive of the diseased. Psychological autopsy does not conclusively decide the case, but throw convincing light about the most probable mode of death in the equivocal death investigation. So many cases we have done in psychological autopsy, death of Rahul Sharma, Santosh Kumar death case, D.K. Ravi IS case, Sunanda Pushkar death case, Sadiq Bacha death case, Burari death case. All of you are aware in Delhi about this Burari death case, 11 persons were hanged there. So on the basis of psychological autopsy study on the disease, the incident was not a suicide, but an accident. Because we collect many data, we collect the information, we read the diary written by the deceased and many other persons. So the incident was not a suicide, but an accident that occurred during the course of performing a ritual. So none of the deceased had an intention to put an end to his life. It was the finding after doing the psychological autopsy in Burari death case. So this is the method we are collecting many information because subjects are not available. We are connecting the information from the family, relatives, diary, medical report. So there is a long procedure and after that we conclude this thing. In Rahul Sharma in IPS death case, this is just summary just for your understanding. So he take the new charge of Bilaspur as SP. So before that sleep disturbance was there. He escaped mill. He left suicide note implicating senior officers. Service weapon was there in close room night time and no defensive wood was present there. So this was the summary and we conducted this autopsy on the basis of follow the proper procedure and after that we find out this summary. So that was the suicide. Forensic psychological assessment. At that time we are behavior of the subject is studied and interpreted through behavior analysis interview technique. The forensic psychologist assess the verbal and nonverbal behavior of the subject. Because in previously I explained you for polygraph, brain mapping and narco, the consent of subject before a judicial magistrate is required. So every time subject is not ready to give the consent. When the investigating officer is investigating the case, the subject is saying, no, I am not going to for any test. I will not give you the consent. Then what the investigating officer will do? So he can go for another test where the consent in front of judiciary is not required. Only the expert will conduct the interview because main objective of the investigating officer is to find out the truth and deception. So he can find out with other technique also. After that, when he submitted the report, the court directed, court ordered, go for the brain mapping, narco and the polygraph test. So many times a subject is not ready for any test, we are doing the forensic psychological assessment. So at that time, the behavior of subject is studied and interpreted through behavior analysis interview. The forensic psychologist assesses the verbal and non-verbal behavior of the subject. Expert frame opinion on the basis of behavioral assessment of the subject. So psychologist measures psychological traits such as personality, emotion, attitude, hostile intent, and other things, and after that he make the opinion. So there are different principle of behavior analysis: verbal channel, paralinguistic channel, and non-verbal channel. So all channel will be analyzed by the expert with the semi-structure interview, structure interview, and with the other technique. So this is the forensic psychological assessment. The way when we are conducting here, we can observe the whole body of the subject. the expert can make the opinion easily and he can observe the verbal and non-verbal behavior of the subjects. So in Delhi High Court bomb blast, Ishrat Jain counter case, Badayun rape, Sadiq Bacha, Archana Desai, Shaila Masood mother case, Nitai killing, in many other cases also, we apply because in many times subject is not ready to give the consent. Then the investigating officer sent a request for other test, then we are conducting this test. And after that, because of this test, many cases it corroborate also, and many times they got the bail also on that basis. There was a one important case in CBI, in SCB branch. It was alleged that some police person raped two girls in their custody. So four police person, two victim and one complainant were the subjected to forensic psychological assessment to find out their involvement. The results suggested that five accused, four police person and one village pradhan were not involved in rape and molestation of the victim. So forensic psychologist convinced the suspected person to undergo the polygraph test for conclusive opinion. Accordingly, the suspected police person given their voluntary consent before the court for the polygraph examination. So result analysis of polygraph examination confirmed that four police person in village pradhan are innocent. They are not involved in the rape of two girls. So forensic psychological assessment interface lead further other test through which the innocence of the suspected police person were established. Layered wise analysis test. It's a non-invasive scientific technique. It identifies the suspect from the voice. It provides instant opinion about truth and deception while making the speech. It analyzes the segment of the speech and provides real-time opinion on the monitor. So LV is described as the window of what the subject is thinking. See, the instrument immediately will tell you where the truth, false, confusion, everything will be written here. False statement. This technique is developed by Amir Lieberman. For research purpose, the instrument is completely computerized and it generates the report on the basis of the voice recorded. LVA system has two main component mode, online mode, real-time analysis, face-to-face or over the phone conversation, and offline mode also. So where we are taking the pre-recorded material, so there is no chance of manipulation. Accuracy of the system is 97%, no language barrier. So here the consent of subject to undergo this test may not require to be made in front of the judiciary. So we are using we are making the closed-ended questionnaire also. Sometime we are taking the open-ended interview also. And on that basis, we are making the opinion. Recently, I attended the case court in Gudiya rape and murder case. I conducted the layered wise analysis on the subject and I attended the court also. So these are the important case: midday meal fire incident in express train at Puri, Odisha, parcel bomb case, Gudiya rape and murder case. We use the layered wise analysis and it conclude that who is involved and who is not involved. So these are the guidelines when any requesting officer is sending the cases to university or to any FSL. So they clear, they send the request with by the competent authority. And they clear the category whether the subject is suspect, victim, witness, and he includes the copy of FIR, defects of case, interrogation report, and justification of subjecting a particular person to forensic psychological technique. IO will justify why he is interested for this person. He will explain each and everything and issues to be proved. Other forensic input, if polygraph and BIOS and narco, then the copy of the consent of subject recorded before magistrate is required. For other technique, this is not required. So Supreme Court of India guidelines. Supreme Court of India guidelines, Srimati Salvi versus State of Karnataka judgment on 5th May 2010. So we hold that no individual should be forcibly subject to any of the technique in question. Means after the Supreme Court judgment, forcefully we cannot compel any person to create any of it, to go for this test, because all these tests are voluntary and the consent of the subject will be recorded in front of the judiciary. So court decided that compelling a person to undergo any lie detection test is unconstitutional. So the consent is very much required, meaning they are used as a corroboratory evidence. The consent should be recorded before a judicial magistrate. And after this Srimati Salvi case, no ban of use of polygraph, narco or BIOS NHRC guideline to be followed strictly. Test report are admissible as a corroboratory evidence after judicial scrutiny. So all these tests extract the information from the mind of the subject. That's why Supreme Court guideline this thing. Supreme, not because of ineffectiveness. So Supreme Court makes some guideline because the expert extracting some information from the mind of the subject. So he make the guideline, you have to follow this procedure and you have to do in this way, not because of its ineffectiveness. So Article 20 sub clause 3. Constitution of India, no person accused of any offense shall be compelled to be a witness against himself. So courts are directed and forwarded case for that detection, mostly used as a scientific aid to investigation, and has to be conducted by a person other than police officer. And during the test, no police person will be present at the time of examination. So legal provisions, it is admissible in section 293 CRPC, discretion to magistrate to admit any evidence based on the nature and circumstances of the case. Section 45 IEA, it includes not only sign, but also the art wherein the expert can give his opinion. And there is an order of 9th October 1969 from Government of India to treat all SSO2 of above CFSL CBI as an ex officio chemical examiner of India. So their reports are admissible in the court. So no court has prevented or objected it. But so it creates the persuasive value. It is a corroborative evidence. It's a aid to investigating agency. And results are interpreted in conjunction with the other material evidence also. So any psychological test doesn't prove guilty or innocence. That is the work of the jury. That will decide. And if anything will come, recovery will done after that, these forensic psychological technique, then it has been taken under Section 27 of Indian Evidence Act, that is admissible. In many cases, after the applying the forensic psychological technique, the results, there were the recovery. So it was taken under Section 27 Indian Evidence Act. Thank you.